star of the show tonight, and we love you to death in this. Yes, sir. Give him another big hand. I'm going to open with a word of prayer, and then we're going to show a tribute video for Johnny and to Johnny, I guess we can say, as soon as I get done. But again, thank everybody for coming out tonight. Appreciate it. And just sit back and enjoy. You're probably going to see as good a show as has been on in the world. We just now getting hot, but they heard me anyhow. Gracious Father in heaven, we thank you for everybody that you've put on this earth. You give each one of us talents. You give each one of us personalities. And you give Johnny Moore just a wonderful personality and a talent. And he has used it for your glory. And we thank him for that. And we ask you to bless him. We pray for his health. We pray that you bless his family. And just give him many more years here on this earth, because we sure enjoy having him. We thank you this evening that many people have come out to enjoy this show, enjoy this time with Johnny. And we ask for your blessing on them. Take us home safely when it's over with. Be with these performers as they perform. And some of them have traveled many miles. And we ask that you take them back home safe as well. We pray for our country, and we pray that Jesus Christ will come back soon, and we will be ready. Being ready is our prayer. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
Here's one of his songs. All around the water tank, waiting for a train. 1,000 miles away from home, sleeping in the rain. I walked up to a brakeman to give him a line of talk. He said, if you've got money, I'll see that you don't walk. Well, I haven't got a nickel, not a penny can I show. He said, get off, you railroad bum. And he slammed the boxcar door. The oldly, oldly, oldly. Well, he put me off in Texas, state I dearly love. Wide open space is all around me, the moon and the stars up above. No one seems to want me or to give me a helping hand. I'm on my way from Frisco, going back to Dixieland. Well, my pocketbook is empty, and my heart is filled with pain. I'm 1,000 miles away from home, just a-waiting for a train. Deodoli, oh-li, oh-li. T for Texas, T for Tennessee. T for Texas, T for Tennessee. T for Thelma, a woman made a wreck out of me. The oldly, oldly, oldly. Now here's one of the songs by old Ernest Tubb, and I'll never forget old Ernest. He was a great singer and one of my heroes. Now if you love your mama and you treat her right, but she keeps on fussing at you every day and night, she gonna trample on you. They'll do it every time. And when your baby starts to step in, Lord, you nearly lose your mind. Now, if your mama's good, take a tip from me. Lock her up at home, but Lord, watch her closely too, because she'll trample on you. They'll do it every time. And when your baby starts to step in, Lord, you nearly lose your mind. Now, if your mama's good, take a tip from me. Lock her up at home, but Lord, watch her closely too, because it's trample on you. They'll do every time. And when your baby starts to step in, Lord, you nearly lose your mind. They nearly drive you crazy. I hope you like that. It goes wrong, and I know you remember this one. It made number one for us. It's over several million. I'm walking the floor over you. I can't sleep a wink, that is true. I'm hoping and I'm praying as my heart breaks right in two. Walking the floor over you. Now, darling, you know I love you well. Love you more than I could ever tell. I thought that you wanted me and always would be mine. But you went and left me here with troubles on my mind. I'm walking the floor over you. I can't sleep a wink, it's true. I'm hoping and I'm praying as my heart breaks right in two. Walking the floor over you. Here's another song I'd like to do by my great friend Lefty Frizzell. We used to do a lot of shows back together in the 50s, early 50s, and I'd like you to sing one of these songs. I know you remember this one, too. If you've got the money, I've got the time. We'll go honky-tonking there. We will have a time. Bring along your Cadillac. Leave my old wreck behind. If you've got the money, honey, I've got the time. There's no use to tarry, so let's start out tonight. We'll spread joy, oh boy, oh boy, and we'll spread it right. We'll have more fun, baby, all the way down the line. If you've got the money, honey, I've got the time. There's no use to tarry, so let's start out tonight. We'll go to the park where it's dark, we won't fool around. You run short of money, I'll run short of time. Cause you with no more money, honey, I've no more time. Now here's another song one of the Lefty Frizzell had out, was the number one song, and we done a lot of shows together back in the 50s, and this is one of my favorites of Lefty's. I'd walk for miles, cry or smile, for my mama and daddy. I want them to know how I feel, my love is real. For my mama and daddy, I want them to know I love them so. In my heart, joy to start, cause I'm happy. And I pray every day for mom and pappy, and each night I'd walk for miles, cry or smile, for my mama and daddy. I want them to know I love them so. I love them so. started writing when I was about 8 years old and finished it by the time I was 11 and recorded it about the age of 15. I had a good record on it. It kind of got me started. And I was worked on a peanut farm and picked cotton. That's where we made a living back in those days. And I wanted to get out of that peanut patch and cotton patch. And so anyway, I hear a song that, that my fiddle player and I wrote, and it got me out of the cotton patch. I got 15 acres of peanut land. I'm not trying to get rich, just a living if I can. Where everybody smiles and the hogs run wild on my 15 acres of peanut land. I first met Susie, we were strolling through the sand. We both barefooted when I asked her for a hand. Said, if you marry me, then soon there'll be three on my 15 acres of peanut land. I got 15 acres of peanut land. I'm not trying to get rich, just a living if I can. Where everybody smiles and the hogs run wild on my 15 acres of peanut land. We raised a few tomatoes and a little bit of peas, a whole lot of cane and a million acre tree. My money's all spent, but I don't owe a cent on my 15 acres of peanut land. I got 15 acres of peanut land. I'm not trying to get rich, just a living if I can. Where everybody smiles and the hogs run wild on my 15 acres of peanut land. 15 acres of peanut land, 15 acres of goober land. There you had one of my songs, one of J.L. Jones, the boy that played the fiddle for me, and hope you liked that one. And here's another song that I recorded and had a good record on it. It's called Gonna Come In Like a Lion.
I'd like to do a little bit of one of my favorite gospel songs of all songs, and
It goes something like this. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. Was grace that taught my heart to see.
That's okay.
The day my mama shot it to everybody's local PTA.
Hey, Bill. I got to tell you, you know, you've always heard what a small world this is. And when I was living in Spring Hill, Louisiana, I had my first top 10 record. And I was on tour with Ernest Tubb and George Jones in Texas. And I had this old beat-up Cadillac. And that sucker broke down. And I coasted in this service station in Texas. And I had about $15. I said, how much you reckon this will take to fix this? He said, probably about $60. I said, $60? And I had my trunk open. He said, you play that guitar? I said, yeah, I'm on the Louisiana Hayride. He said, no kidding. He said, I'll tell you what, I get this fixed for you if you'll do a little picking and singing while we're working on it. I said, man, let me get my guitar out. I was singing all the songs, and he said, you know, I got a niece that really is a good singer. And I said, you know, oh, no kidding. Oh, that's great, yeah. Well, keep encouraging her, you know. Hey, maybe one day. And so Harper Valley PTA was a monster hit. I saw this guy named Johnny Moore.
Oh, my uncle.
My uncle. He said, bro, how's your car running? I said, this is the niece.
That's a great story.
How is Johnny Moore?
He's wonderful.
He's a great guy.
He's really the guy that brought me to town and gave me the first jamboree to sing on back home. And I wouldn't be here today without him.
He was talking about you big when I was picking and singing and working on my car.
He used to come up here and record for Star Day Records, and that's how I knew to come to Nashville. You know, I knew that the Grand Ole Opry came off the radio, but I didn't really think about where it was coming from. It was just coming off the radio, and I love it. But my uncle made me aware that Nashville's Music City, USA, and the place to be if you wanted to make country music.
Thank you so much. It was a great pleasure entertaining you here today. God bless you.
Times. Well, little Miss Bo Peep, you've done lost your sheep. So tonight I'm gonna come in like a lion. Yes, tonight I'm gonna come in like a lion.
Yeah, welcome to the
Palace, everybody. Woo, Jason Adams for you. Oh, man, we're glad to be back here. It's been a while. Glad to be back for the reason we're here for. So y'all know a little about Johnny from the video. We'll tell you a few more things as we go along. Billy Loggins, the city's marketing director, is here. He's got a little something for Mr. Johnny. Billy, come on.
Hey, it's an honor to be here tonight, representing the city of Crossville and Cumberland County, and to honor Johnny Moore and his outstanding career. If he would come up, I'd like to present him with a proclamation that declares March the 10th, 2017, as Johnny Moore Day in Crossville and Cumberland County.
Yeah, that's right. That's two of them now. He's got one out in Anson, Texas, where he's from. They do a annual Johnny Moore Day out there, been doing it for years. And so, boy, he's getting busy. He's going to have to buy another bus, I guess, to get around all these places.
I'll tell you what an honor it is to be here tonight with all my friends. I've had so many friends, and I hope I'm still their friend. But I just want to thank them so much, and there's so many of them that's given me Brock Hill, and a whole bunch of them has given me things like that. I can't believe that they thought enough of me to do that. But I want you to know I just love all of you. They're singing songs, and Tommy Cash is going to be here, and his son Mark Cash. Oh, there's going to be so many here that they're really great friends of mine. I'll never forget them. I love y'all. God bless you. Thank you.
Thank you, Johnny. You talk about an honor for the staff band. Johnny Moore's been a good friend to us, and we're racking up some of those guys along the way, and it's an honor for us to have him with us. We put together some other singers for this show, and man, if you stand behind them, you better play, because there's some talented folks in front of you. No question about that. I want to tell you this, and this is a big deal, and y'all got to help us. Tonight's show is aired around the world on WFMCJams.com. Out of Manchester, Tennessee. They were good enough to come. And you're live on the air around the world. What about it, Crossville? Woo! All right. Woo. Well, I never thought I'd, I've played in the basement most of my career. Never thought I'd have that opportunity. All right. Johnny Moore's son, Johnny G., is going to come out and sing for us. There was a tribute album done that Johnny was involved in. I want Johnny G to tell us a little bit about that. Come on, Johnny G.
Thank you. Dad's always a hard act to follow. Dad, on that album that you did, that was that at Starlight? Is that where we did that? You did that at the studio? Yeah. I don't know a lot of details about that. I just know that Jim and he were like comrades in music, and their stories went back a long ways, and their paths crossed quite a few times, and Jim had asked Dad to be on the airplane with him to look at real estate, and Dad had another venue to be at himself with a contract. So he had to tell Jim, I can't go. And then that weekend, during the week, I forget what day it is, in 1964, I was just 2 years old. I never got to meet Jim myself, but Dad is here by fate. And Jim perished that weekend. I'm glad my dad's still around. Well, we sure miss Jim Reeves, too. And Jim is a man as hard, just like Elvis. You try to cover his songs. If you can't do it justice, you shouldn't do it at all. So I'm going to just give it a good shot, and we'll see what we can come out with. We're going to roll out with the Distant Drums for the first song. I hear the sound of distant drums far away, far away. And if they call, let's not wait. Let's share all the time we can before it's too late. Love me now, for now is all the time there may be. If you love me, marry, marry, marry me. I hear the sound of bugles blow far away, far. They call for me to go, then I must go, and you must stay. So marry, marry me, let's not change our wedding date. And love me now, for now is all the time there may be. If you love me, marry, marry, marry me.
Yeah, what about that? Woo, son, now that's country right there.
You can't get no more country than that.
Mercy.
Oh, I hope I did that all right. We got some folks that's listening in at the Reeves family, and Lainey Arnold is in Louisiana. She's taking care of Jim Reeves' enterprises now. And, oh, my goodness. Miss Jackson was a secretary from the 50s on, and Joyce Jackson, today is her birthday. So if you're listening in, we want to say happy birthday to Joyce Jackson.
All right. You going to tell how old she is, Johnny?
Well, sure.
Don't you do it.
Joyce, we love you, okay? We're going to try another one here, and this is Jim's. So I'd like to say one thing. I did get to meet Mary Reeves, and with Dad having service stations, because of my dad, I got to meet a lot of folks, from Lefty Frizzell, Marty Robbins, all the way to Dave Dudley and Conway Twitty, Laura Lynn, Lefty Frizzell, and the Cashes on top of that, with Tommy, Miss the happiest girl in the USA, Miss Donna Fargo. So they had parked their buses there with us, and just because of my daddy, I got to grow up around those folks. Mary told me, she said, son, whatever you do, I want you to listen to my husband's music. So as a kid, I sat down and I listened to his songs at Daddy's Jukebox. And I learned those things, Snowflake and all those songs. So
hey, Johnny,
because of Mary, yes, sir.
What was the price on the jukebox in that day?
What's that?
What was the price on the jukebox in that day?
Oh, goodness, it's 10 cents or a nickel.
Ten, hey, that's cheap, yeah. Buddy.
But Dad had one we had in our basement, so that's right. Yeah.
Well, let's do it.
We're going to do it. We're going to go. He'll have to go, all right, and see. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man to turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you, he'll have to go. Whisper to me, tell me, do you love me true? Or is he holding you the way I do? Though love is blind, make up your mind, I've got to know. Should I hang up, or will you tell him he'll have to go? You can't say the words I wanna hear while you're with another man. Do you want answer yes or no? Darling, I will understand. Put your sweet lips a little closer to the phone. Let's pretend that we're together all alone. I'll tell the man turn the jukebox way down low. And you can tell your friend there with you, he'll have to go.
Yeah. Thank you, Johnny. He's going to be back with us shortly. Hey, what about the backup singers back here? Did y'all hear that? Woo! Stacy McElhaney and Mr. Rob Baker, one of my oldest and dearest music friends in this county. Oh, man. Anthony Woolbright, name y'all might know, works down to the Food City. He's the assistant head man down there, assistant to the assistant. This guy was he sang at home in the shower. His lovely wife, Cheryl, said, look here, you got to go.
Dry off and let's go.
Yeah. So we brought him out here and put him on stage, dressed him up, got him a nice new shirt, cool looking hat, pressed his hat, and here he is.
Brought it last night, actually. Thank you.
off to school. He spent his hard-earned money so his boy wouldn't be a fool. Tried to be a successful man instead of sleeping in the rain. Put a little daddy down, I heard the whistle of a train. Train whistles have written my life. They cost me my family and they cost me a loving wife. Train whistles, I hate to hear them blow. Cause when they blow, I always go.
Come on, Billy Sims.
Hey, we want to thank the City of Crossville at the Palace Theater. They have bent over backwards for the staff band. We appreciate it. Southern Rascal Sound, our sound engineer for tonight, Mr. Christian Fontaine. He's got a resume longer from here to back door, so I had to hire him. Thank you, Christian.
Let's see here.
Oh, Anthony.
I think they're going to let me do two in a row.
Yeah, come on with it.
I feel special.
While you're here.
I feel like I'm pretty, pretty good company tonight. She awakes, warm and willing, as I kiss her tenderly, satin pearl. On satin pillows with satin skin touching me. Then she gives me good morning loving, fulfilling every dream of mine. Oh, how I love her morning loving. Good morning, girl. Looking fine.
Luther Myers for you.
I did not know when I met her. I did not care or want to learn. Just let me throw my arms around her and feel the fire that always burns. When she gives me good morning loving, fulfilling every dream of mine. Oh, how I love her morning loving. Good morning, world. You're looking fine. Good morning.
and sure, oh, you're looking fine.
Yeah,
thank you.
Thank you, Cheryl, for letting him come play with us. Jack Melling, come out here. I want you to tell me how long you've known Mr. Johnny Moore.
I moved here in 04.
Yeah.
And I met him just shortly after I moved here.
Uh-huh.
And he used to go into Walmart, and there was a guy that worked in produce that played a harmonica.
Uh-oh.
And he used to get that guy to play the harmonica while he was working.
Uh-huh.
And I thought, how does he do that? But I found out, well, it's Johnny Moore. That's how he does it. Johnny and I have been pretty good friends, and I played music with him often, and I really appreciate my buddy. I'm going to sing you a song. It's an old Hank Williams song that Johnny did. And by the way, this will be my last show here because I'm going back to Michigan.
Michigan?
Yes, sir.
Wait a minute.
I'm going up in the cold.
Did you check with the band before you decided to just leave?
Well, when I came down here, I told them I was from down south.
And
nobody believed me, but no. I'm from southern Michigan.
Look here. Anything north of Jamestown, Tennessee is too far north.
Well, Luther wanted me to remind you guys that I introduced Luther to Johnny Moore, and I didn't remember that until just the other day. He told me the story about how I did that. And Johnny was in the hospital, and Luther was his nurse. And I thought, I never knew that. I thought Luther knew him. They're up there singing songs, and Luther's taking blood, and Johnny's singing songs, and he's just having a good time up there. No matter where he goes, he has fun. He does. He does that real well.
That's a great story, Jack. Thank you. Let's do it.
Do a little window shopping. Window shopping. Looking around, you're not buying, you're just trying to find the best deal in town. You give away your kisses, but you never give your heart to anyone who's fool enough to fall. Feel love, you don't want real love, your window, that's all. I'll pick it now, boy. You never give your heart. drop in, that's all. We love you, Johnny Moore. We love you, buddy.
Thank you, Jack.
Thank you.
Woo. Yeah, we loaded tonight. Let's see. Oh, man, this guy right here. If you're ever up in Nashville and you happen to go by a little place called the Nashville Palace, you know it or not, but this, you might see this guy on the stage, Parker Pressley.
Thank y'all. Appreciate it. What a good-looking crowd out there. You're welcome, Luther. Love you, Johnny.
Take these boots and give me back my walking shoes. I've got a lot of walking to do. The last few years are full of miseries with you. And I've got a lot of walking to do. My old car broke down and it just won't untrack. Everything I'm taking track here on my back. I'll walk the soles right off of these shoes and I hate coming back. And I've got a lot of walking to do. Take these boots and give me back my walking shoes. I've got a lot of walking to do. Last few years are full of miseries with you. And I've got a lot of walking to do. Hit the interstate and headed west. I've got a hurting way down in my chest. My heart's breaking cause I know that you and I are through. Still I've got a lot of walking to do. Take these boots and give me back my walking shoes. I've got a lot of walking to do. Last few years are full of miseries with you. And I've got a lot of walking to do. Take these boots and give me back my walking shoes. I've got a lot of walking to do. The last few years are full of miseries with you. And I've got a lot of walking to do. And I've got a lot of walking to do.
Yeah. Parker Pressley. Thank you, bud. Woo. Let's see here. Have I missed anything? Anniversary tonight. Going to Gatlinburg after the show. You get to clean up.
Okay.
Woo. All right. Rob Baker, come on. This guy right here is kind of a legend around these parks. He's pretty hard to follow. He's pretty hard to lead, too.
Don't overdo it now. Johnny Moore and I have been friends for a good long while now. And I understand he's very giving and accommodating and all this. Won't you know he gave me a coupon to Hardee's? 99 cents for biscuit and gravy. I got to look at it and it expired in 2007.
Oh, what are we gonna do now?
He's a damn. I love him. He's got the best wife. She's a great songwriter too, and I understand she wrote this song that I'm fixing to render.
Thank you.
my heart, let me hear. All alone and blue, somehow I just can't believe that I'm over you. I lie awake to my heart, I'm not through hurting you, but I can't have a heart alive. I can't tell my heart that I don't care for you. I don't even care what you do. That we're mighty lucky to be rid of you, but I can't tell my heart a lie. More than you, one who share my life and never be untrue. And I will not compare and wish that they were you, but I can't tell my heart a lie. I can't tell my heart I don't care for you, and I don't even care what you do. That we are mighty lucky I can't tell my heart a lie.
Yeah, Rob Baker for you, folks. That's another legend right there in the music business. Thank you, bud. Pretty smooth, bud. Well, she can do it, can't she?
I have for you a sweetheart from Texas, Mom. I have for you a sweetheart from Texas on the phone to be a part of this show and this tribute to my daddy. You may have heard of her. Back in 1968, I lost my best babysitter, and I remember as a child moving her up here from Texas. If you remember the song Harper Valley PTA that Tom T. Hall wrote, she took that thing to number one. Boy, it bloomed from there, and Jeannie's life changed basically overnight. And she's back in Texas to be a part of this show on audio, and she's going to be listening in live to the recordings on the internet radios. Her mama, Aunt Nora, and Uncle Oscar, or their husband, my dad's sister. I hope that Aunt Nora's listening too. Hi, Jeannie.
Hi, Johnny G. How you doing?
I'm doing great, and we're glad to have the time and taking the time to honor my daddy here for this tribute show. And we are definitely not putting him out the pasture. We're just to help him feel a little better and keep him going, get him back up here on this stage. And hopefully you too.
Yeah. If you did put my Uncle Johnny out to pasture, he'd still move out than all the others. He'd be the one with the bell around his neck, and the rest of them would all follow him around. In that case, he'd be a she, though, instead of a he, and we know that he's a he, he would be a bull. If he was out to pasture, he'd be a bull. He wouldn't be a cow. But I'm all twisted up here. But anyway, I want to congratulate Uncle Johnny on this tribute show that y'all put together for him. Johnny G, you and Luther Meyer. Luther's been with Uncle Johnny through thick and thin. He's been everything from lead guitar player to band leader to chauffeur, you name it. I've met Luther coming and going, and he's certainly one of Uncle Johnny's very best friends. And I want to thank you, Johnny G, for learning all the songs for the tribute show, that Uncle Johnny can sit back and relax and enjoy his music without having to do it himself.
You sure are helping add to it, Jeannie.
I'm glad to. I wish I could be there to see it in person, but I'll be listening, and my thoughts will be with you, and my prayers will be with you. I just want Uncle Johnny to know that he has an abundance of friends and family who just want him to know how much they care about him. Uncle Johnny, you've always had a dream of contributing your kind of country to the music business, and there's just so many of us who love you and share that dream with you. And now, though I'm retired at the present, don't be too surprised if I, too, bounce back into the music business, before very long, even. If you've ever been bit by the country music bug, you may at any time in life break out into new symptoms by singing around the house, running people out of the room, by playing music so loud that it gets on the nerves. And when we talk, it takes a hold of our conversations as we dream out loud about singing and writing and performing. But, you know, that's all a gift from God. When God has anointed us to do the music, he will open the doors of opportunity for that music to be channeled into the direction that he has chosen. And that's where I am right now, just waiting on the Lord, waiting for his direction. And Uncle Johnny, you've already got your calling, and you've been quite successful at it. I want to congratulate you for being inducted into the Texas Country Music Hall of Shame. Oh, excuse me, I mean the Texas Country Music Hall of Fame. I support you in your desire to perform. The Lord tells us in Psalm 37:4 to delight ourselves in him, and he will give us the desires of our heart. And in other words, as we put him first in our lives, then he gives us our heart's desires. He says to seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these other things will be added unto us. So be sure to always keep on being a witness for the Lord Jesus Christ like you've been doing in the past, Uncle Johnny. And the Lord will just keep opening doors to you that no man can shut. And he loves it so much when we sing his praises. So I want to join you, Uncle Johnny, and Johnny G, and Luther Meyer, and all of you. I'm going to shout with you, praise the Lord. God inhabits the praises of his people, and I know he's with us all right now. I love you, Uncle Johnny, and I thank all the good folks who've worked so hard to make this night possible for you. Johnny G, he's poured his heart and soul into it and learned all the songs that you've done in the past so that you can just sit back and fold your arms and enjoy listening. But now you're going to get up and do one song. You better do that Losing by a Hair. That's my favorite. Now, God bless you and all those that you hold dear and love, Uncle Johnny. And that includes you, Aunt Chocolate. I love y'all. This is Jeannie C. signing off. Well, thank you for including me.
Jeannie C. Riley, ladies and gentlemen. If it wasn't for Johnny Moore, we probably would not get to enjoy Harper Valley PTA. That's a big deal. All right, Johnny G., come on. Uh-oh, wait a minute. A technical difficulty. Coach and you was talking. I've seen that show before. Let's see. WFMCJams.com out of Manchester. Tickled to death we're on your station and around the world, and well, at least in Crab Orchard. Who knows? All right, Johnny, you ready?
Okay, this song right here, we're going to wake you guys up. You know, these tickets were pretty cheap, so you're going to have to earn these, all right? You're going to be singing on this song. I want to talk a little bit about this song before we get started. J.L. Jones and my dad were comrades in music. He was a great fiddle player. He could sing, but he wanted somebody else to do all the singing. So between them two, they wrote songs together. This song here is one that J.L. Jones wrote. And Tammy and Dina are the daughters. They're listening in live right now tonight down in Texas. All right.
This is a song, it's called More Indians, and this is as political as I'm going to get because you see enough of it on Facebook already. More Indians is the name of the song, and I'm going to do this right here. I'm going to go More Indians when I kick it off, and then you're going to follow with the More Indians right behind me, okay? We're just going to practice one time. Can we do that? All right. More Indians.
More Indians.
More Indians. Okay, that's how we're going to do it. Can you do the...
That's pretty simple right there.
All right, I want to hear it.
Do that. Let's go. All right.
More Indians. More Indians. There should be a lot more Indians and a lot less Indian chiefs. Seems like everybody's trying to be a big whale. There's ordinary people, no, just run of the mill. I ain't got much education on the street of my belief. There should be a lot more Indians and a lot less Indian chiefs. More Indians.
More Indians.
More Indians.
More Indians.
There should be a lot more Indians and a lot less Indian chiefs. When we all move to the White House, who's gonna pay the rent? Who's gonna go do the voting when we're all president? If we all eat higher on the hog, who's gonna eat the beef? There should be a lot more Indians and a lot less Indian chiefs. More Indians.
More Indians.
More Indians. There should be a lot more Indians and a lot less Indian chiefs. More Indians.
More Indians.
More Indians.
More
Indians.
Oh. Yeah.
Thank y'all. Isn't that a fun song?
Folks, we're going... stop just for a minute, and then we're coming back, and there's a surprise sitting back over there waiting, and you ain't going to want to miss it, so don't get up, go nowhere, because if you miss it, you're going to be upset. We enjoyed having you so far. We hope you've had a big time. We'll be back in just a few minutes with a pretty doggone good surprise.
Hey, this is Mark, the DJ Doctor. Rip off your control, alt, and delete buttons and listen to the internet's newest radio show, WFMCJams.com.
The Midnight Madness Show is a show dedicated to songwriters and artists alike. You never know who is going to be here or what's going to happen. So tune in every Tuesday at 7 p.m. Central Time. Sit back, sing along, and have a great time hanging out with us. Myself, Jason Adams, the Hillbilly Heartthrob. The DJ Doctor, Mr. Mark Irish. Uncle Lair, Larry Zagranis. Rockin' Randall, Randy Fincham. And the IT guru genius himself, Brian Howell. Recorded live right here at the Last Chance Saloon at 8144 McMinnville Highway in Morrison, Tennessee.
Hey, this is Randy Fincham, and I'd like to invite you personally to listen to the Nashville Night Show every week, 8:30 p.m. Central Time to 10 p.m. Central Time, right here on the Nashville Songwriters Radio Network. We broadcast live from the Last Chance Saloon right south of Nashville, where it's a fertile ground of talent, where we're going to interview a mixture of successful Nashville, national, and international singers and songwriters. You never know what you're going to get week after week. Be sure to be listening, and I can't wait to hear from you. And every week right here on the Nashville Night Show on the Nashville Songwriters Radio Network.